All right, my name is Ronnie Richards, and this is my wife, Katie Richards. We have three kids, Nicholas, Tyler, and Avery. Our son Tyler, our middle son, was diagnosed with a brain tumor in April of 2018.
So we started to notice signs that Tyler wasn't hitting milestones when he was 9 months old.
A lot of core development things that were just missing or retracted. And so like holding forks and spoons kind of went away after kind of mastering it at some point. And so that was very kind of telling, you know, something's going on. And
so we went ahead and called for a neurologist, told him how our son was regressing, not hitting milestones. And he said, you're correct, you need an MRI. And when Ty was still in the middle of the procedure, they informed us that they didn't know too much. They just knew there was a mass in his brain. At the meeting, we found out that the mass starts in his right thalamus and then expands with roots down into his cerebellum, other major parts, a lot of parts of his brain, which makes this tumor inoperable. He had a biopsy done, a needle biopsy, and we found the BRAF mutation in it. And we were told we were very lucky to find this mutation. So UCSF informed us that the tumor, the brain cancer, was slow growing. And so we waited and we watched it. And it grew very, very slow and very little over a year. Then it started to grow faster. And that's when we decided that we needed to do treatment. And we knew that we didn't want his last days or months to be spent in the hospital on chemo treatment if this tumor was going to take his life. And we wanted him to live it up, live every minute, every moment. But then we were offered a chance to take a new treatment. Science is amazing. They came out with inhibitors to target his exact mutation. And we've been on the treatment now for over 2.5 years with a stable tumor.
Tyler's current treatment is 2 medicines daily. He takes it in the morning and at night. He's such a champ. He takes it every day. He kind of puts his hand up that he took his medicine. So it feels good. I know it wears on him every day, but he does it. It's been 2.5 years, and I just cross my fingers he continues to participate. What excites me about Tyler today is he's a happy boy. And I like that he wants to experience things that maybe he didn't a few years ago or that he sees his siblings in today. He's excited. He likes to dance. We like to have dance parties. He turns on his favorite music and he's starting to move quite a bit. So it's fun to watch. It also excites me that he's into more physical things, things that we thought maybe weren't possible in the past. He's been riding a bike for the past couple of years, a trike. And seeing him pedal and just get the natural ability is exciting to see, and I'm hoping for much more. We've recently visited a theme park, and he's kind of daring. He likes to go on rides and bumper cars and other little fast rides.
No birthday, Edo.
Having that experience with him and seeing that he wants to do that is pretty exciting.
The fact that Tyler is continuing to develop at his own speed is so exciting to me, and he is constantly always smiling and happy. I love hearing his laugh and giggle. Our whole goal is quality of life and making those memories. As long as he is feeling great the way that he is, we feel blessed to have this way of treating it and keeping it stable.
As a parent, I would hope that in the future, more funding could be available to educational institutions, cancer research organizations, and cancer foundations. Just put more money into the pot to allow other areas of research and development to occur.
If I could stand in front of Congress, I would let them know, how would you want your child to be treated if they got cancer tomorrow? I feel that more funding needs to go towards childhood cancer and other cancer to find cures for each cancer. We need more funding, more trials, more studies, so that we can start curing these cancers.